So what are some of the most common questions you get from pre-PAs?
So a lot of the common questions, especially around this time and maybe a few months before, was about the application process. So all that, maybe just answer questions about that. What does it include, the application process? So at the beginning, you send in your transcript, and that's it. So you don't send in a reference, you don't send in a CV. It asks you like what some of the things you've done after undergrad, but I also applied. I was within university students, so maybe my application was a little bit different, but that's what I remember. And then you send that in, and then if you make the GPA cutoff, which is a 3.0, then you're provided the email with the sub app, I think. And then the supplementary application is a video/written interview that you do online at home. And it's two video questions and two written questions. You watch a video of someone asking a question, and then you record a video of yourself answering that question within a time limit. And there's two of those, and there's two written questions. You read a question, and then you write your answer, you type your answer within the time limit. And so that's what the sub app is. So I get a lot of questions of advice for the supplementary application. And my advice is practice, which was my advice from before. Practicing is really good. But before you practice, you have to know, obviously, what the supplementary application will be like, and also just general theories and ideas of answering supplementary application or interview style, MMI style questions, or CASPER, which is something that people write for med school and nursing, which is kind of just situational and just questions that you can expect in an interview. And learning about those, learning about the different perspectives, the different approaches that people take. Obviously, the four different I forget what they're called, but they're the pillars of kind of healthcare, of the autonomy, the beneficence, the non-maleficence, and justice, and understanding what those four are. But also, outside of that, when you're getting into the practice, just practice talking. Just practice speaking out loud to a camera, because that's a very unnatural thing, even though I'm doing it right now. But it's something you have to get used to, something you have to get comfortable with, and become, when you're comfortable and confident, you come across like you know what you're talking about, and like you can be in any situation and not falter. Because as much as the supplementary application is looking at what you say, they're looking at how you say it. So if you are really uncomfortable, or if you are stammering or stuttering or saying ums or ahs, or kind of a deer in the headlights, that's not a good sign. So I think recording yourself and watching for those little things in your demeanor and your posture and your facial expression, I think, and then teasing those things out, taking and out of your vocabulary, which is one of the hardest things to do, is something to work on, especially because it's a video interview and you're not talking to a human, you're literally talking to a camera, and that it feels very different than talking to a person. So being able to do that, so practicing is huge.